beautiful?
Oh. Did you say something, Margarita?
The swan that's wearing that crown.
Huh?
Isn't she magnificent?
Just a minute!
Where are you going, Hans?
Well, it might be a little big, huh? And here you are.
What is it?
Now, Princess Margarita, close your eyes.
Close my eyes? I can hardly wait. Oh, maybe that could be Prince Siegfried from the castle. I don't like you, Hans.
Wait for me, Margarita.
Gallant and dignified. So different from Hans.
Oh, stop comparing me with Prince Siegfried. Just tell me when you will become my bride.
Don't talk nonsense. I wouldn't marry you. Look. Isn't he wonderful? Oh.
Look out!
Thank you, Hans. Impossible, Hans.
Very strange. I feel as if I were being stared at by a beautiful lady.
Prince! Prince! Is something wrong?
Look over there.
Oh? What's that? A swan wearing a crown on its head?
A very curious bird.
Oh, look at that swan!
I'll get that strange swan with the crown for you with one arrow.
No, don't! Adolf has been turned into stone.
Prince, this is a magic forest. It must be the doing of that swan with the crown.
You think so?
Oh. Let's leave this place. We shouldn't stay here a moment longer.
Thank you.
very strange.
No, there's nothing strange about it at all. That swan with the crown practices witchcraft. Come to think of it, no one has ever been to the other side of that lake.
But still, I can't possibly believe that magnificent, noble swan could practice witchcraft.
But Prince, it's a fact that Adolf was turned into stone when he tried to shoot that swan. It would be best for you never to go near that lake again.
Prince Siegfried, the Queen has come to visit you.
Oh, Mother.
Siegfried, tomorrow is your birthday, the day when you will become an adult.
Yes.
Because your father passed away, tomorrow you will automatically become the king of our country.
Yes.
And at the ball tomorrow, you will have to choose someone to be your bride.
Choose a bride?
That's right. The king who is going to rule this country needs a queen.
But...
You needn't worry. I have already sent invitations to 6 of the most beautiful princesses whom I've selected from our neighboring kingdoms. And I will let you choose the one you would like to be your queen from among the princesses.
But, Mother, can't it wait?
Oh, no. Since you are going to become an adult, you should also have a wife. Or do you have someone whom you already like?
No, there is no one.
Then do as I say.
Yes.
Congratulations, Prince Siegfried.
Benno, stop being funny. Just because I'm suddenly becoming a king, why must I choose someone I don't even love to be my queen? There is nothing to congratulate me about.
Oh.
But it is what my mother wants, and I cannot disobey her.
It can't be helped. You were born as a crown prince. And this is your fate.
I know that very well.
What is it?
That strange swan with the crown. I must see it again.
What are you saying?
That swan fascinates me.
But that swan can practice witchcraft.
If it really practices witchcraft like you say it does, I want to see it and plead with it to release Adolf from that terrible spell.
You can't do that. What if something should happen to you?
No, Penno. I cannot believe that a beautiful swan can practice witchcraft.
But,
Don't try to stop me, Benno.
Oh.
I wonder why this statue is standing here. Hans! Hans! What is it, Margarita?
Look, the swan with the crown on its head is leaving.
Adolf, be patient.
Oh, it's Prince Siegfried.
Over there. Look, only the swan with the crown is leaving. Let's follow it.
Right.
Hans, come on. Just don't stand there.
Oh, do I have to come?
Ah, the road ends here.
Prince, let's give up and go back now.
Yeah! Yeah!
is impossible. We can't ride up this steep slope.
Oh, the prince is so gallant and brave.
The other man just can't make it.
Wait for me! Prince! Prince!
Margarita!
What is it, Hans?
Where are you going now?
You're so stupid. You should know better than to ask.
You don't have to call me stupid all the time, do you? Can you be anyway, calling the prince like that?
Come on!
Yeah!
How far is that swan going to go? Terrible looking place.
The swan became a beautiful lady.
It's the forest of witchcraft. Let's go back.
Don't be afraid. Remember, Prince Siegfried is with us.
Prince Siegfried.
Why is it you know my name? And you, just who are you? And why were you like a swan just now?
My real name is Princess Odette.
Odette? Odette, tell me, are you a human being, or are you really a swan?
I am a human being like you, but an evil wizard transformed me into a white swan.
An evil wizard did that?
Yes. And it is only during the hours of darkness that I am permitted to take the shape of a human being again.
And then, the one who turned Adolf into stone?
It was Rothbart's doing.
Rothbart?
Didn't you see a strange-looking owl in the forest?
Why, yes, I did see an owl.
That was the wizard Rothbart, the owl's evil spirit.
The owl's spirit?
You must go back quickly, Prince Siegfried. The wizard Rothbart could be watching us even now.
Then this castle belongs to Rothbart?
This is the castle of the wicked wizard.
Oh, I hope that Prince Siegfried will be safe.
Let me take care of Rothbart.
Please wait, Prince Siegfried.
Don't stop me. I must release Adolf from the spell.
No. Rothbart could never be harmed by any ordinary human being.
How do you know he can't be harmed?
We tried to fight against Rothbart, and he destroyed my country.
Your country? He destroyed your country?
I was the princess of another country. And 3 years ago, Rothbart came and asked for my hand in marriage. He was very persistent. My father and I both refused. And then our country was totally destroyed, and he kidnapped and brought me here.
But why does Rothbart change you into a white swan like that?
He believes it will prevent me from ever meeting any other men.
But why?
If a man should appear who really and truly loved me with his whole heart and soul, Rothbart would lose his evil power. And he turns me into a swan during the days so that no one will fall in love with me.
Is that true? Really?
Yes. When Rothbart brought me here to his castle, he changed me into a white swan to prove his power.
If that's true, my love will destroy Rothbart.
Don't say that. Because then Rothbart will...
No. When I first saw you today as a beautiful swan on the lake, I felt a strong attraction toward you. When you looked at me, with those eyes, with those same beautiful eyes, Odette. Odette. Odette, tomorrow night at my castle, there will be a grand ball to celebrate my birthday, and I must choose a bride. Will you please come? And then I will choose you to be my bride.
No. You mustn't. You cannot.
Odette, I beg you, come to the castle, and there we will pledge our love, and then there will be nothing more to fear.
Even though I would like to go to your castle, Rothbart would never let me go. Farewell, Prince Siegfried.
Odette, wait.
Please go quickly. Rothbart is a terrible man.
Tomorrow, will you come? I'll be waiting. I swear, I have no intention of marrying anyone else but you. Please come tomorrow.
You must go. Unless you leave now, I can't promise to come.
I'll go. But you must promise me to come.
Yes.
I'll be waiting.
Oh, no, no, 燃えた月日。 father is still fast asleep. Father, wake up now. It's already dark. You look so terribly tired. Is something wrong with you?
Oh, it's because I changed a man into stone when he tried to kill Odette, and it makes me tired when I practice witchcraft in broad daylight. Well, I'll get up now.
Father, you certainly are crazy about Odette.
Yes, 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 yes! The night is my realm, my world to live in, and I will propose marriage to Odette again tonight. Tonight she might accept me. My precious little Odette. Just one more time.
Father, I don't think you should keep your hopes up.
Why not?
Because your precious little Odette was seeing a young man today.
What? Why didn't you tell me all of this first?
What are you saying? It's because you were so involved with your sweet daydreams.
Never mind all that. Just tell me. What kind of man is he?
Are you worried?
Of course I am.
I hate to admit it, but he certainly is gallant, that handsome young Prince Siegfried.
Prince Siegfried?
Yes, the Crown Prince.
Is that really true?
Of course. And he invited her to come to his castle tomorrow night, and then he will choose her as his bride.
Why, that Prince Siegfried! This is unforgivable!
Oh, be careful, Father!
Where is he? Where is he? Siegfried, where are you? Where are you hiding? I'll find you no matter where you are.
You won't find him around here.
He's not here?
He went home long ago.
What about Odette?
Well, now, I am pretty sure she's sitting around dreaming of her love for Siegfried. Now that such a good-looking, gallant, and young prince has shown up, you'll find it more difficult.
Be quiet!
Oh, you scare me.
Now that things have come to this, I must handle Odette without mercy.
I'll bring out all the lizards, toads, spiders, bats, and fire-breathing dragons to keep Siegfried away from my little Odette.
Odette, Odette, my little Odette. How are you this fine evening, Odette? Who was that man you met today? Young Prince Siegfried from the castle?
How did you know?
You really don't think something like that could happen without my knowledge, do you? Well, well, let's forget him now. Odette, isn't it just about the time for you to decide to accept my humble offer of marriage? I've been very patient waiting all these years. And tonight, give me the answer that would overwhelm my heart with great happiness. Oh, my precious Odette, just promise to marry me and I will give you anything in the world that you desire. I give my solemn oath that you will have a far more luxurious life than any queen. Hmm? Why don't you answer me? Could it be that you detest talking to me? If you refuse to accept my generous offer of marriage, you must continue to live each day as a swan. Don't you mind that?
I do not wish to live a luxurious life. There is nothing that I really want, except that I...
Except? What is it you wish?
I wish to live with someone I love.
Someone you love? Don't say it. It can't be true. Don't tell me. Don't tell me that this someone you love and wish to live with is Siegfried. Odette, I am the someone who loves you and wants to live with you. And still, tell me, why is it that you can't fall in love with me?
Use your witchcraft to do it. There is nothing you can't do. You're the greatest wizard in the world.
Enough! Enough! Even with my splendid skill, it is impossible to move a human heart. If it was possible to make you love me, I wouldn't have waited for these last 3 years. Oh, Odette, won't you please take pity on me? How long do you intend to keep me waiting like this? Or do you still think that you are in love with Siegfried?
Yes.
It's stupid, falling in love with such a young boy whom you've just met.
No, you are wrong. I have been in love with Siegfried all of these years.
For all of these years, you say?
Yes. I often saw Prince Siegfried riding his horse down by the lake.
So that's the real reason why you don't like me even one little bit. Don't make me angry any more than I am right now, Odette. If I really wanted to, I could turn you into an ugly toad, or even a worm, or a tiny bug, or even into a caterpillar. But I didn't do that to you. I kept you in the beautiful figure of a swan. Do you understand why? Because I am so deeply in love with you, and it's proof of my real love.
It's not. If you were really and truly in love with me, you would have done nothing to make me sad. Now, Rothbart, if you truly love me as you say, then right now, go away and leave me alone. Please, leave this room at once.
How dare you? How dare you say a thing like that, Odette? So you wish to attend the prince's ball? Ha! You think I'd let you go? You think so? You think so? Well, you had better think twice about it.
Oh, forgive me, please.
Well, Odette, like a pretty bird in a cage. Tomorrow night at the ball, Prince Siegfried will be forced to choose someone else to give his love to and be his bride.
Prince Siegfried. Siegfried.
I should never let myself get soft-hearted over that little Odette.
Pretty good idea what put you in this terrible mood.
What is so funny about it?
So she turned you down again, Father.
Quiet!
Forget it. Odette will never be your wife. It's hopeless no matter how long you wait.
Enough is enough!
I bet you hate her now, don't you?
I hate her. She's breaking my heart, so I hate her very much.
Then why don't you kill her? All you have to do is kill her. You can't wait forever, but Odette will never become your bride. So kill her and get rid of her. Don't you think it's a good idea?
No, that's something I can't do. I could never kill my beautiful and precious little Odette.
Oh, you're so soft-hearted. Then if you can't do it, I don't mind doing it for you.
No, don't do it, Odile. Don't do it. I'm too much in love with Odette. I love her so much.
Yes, she will come. I'm sure she will.
But, Prince, if the wizard Rothbard uses his power...
Don't say that. I've already made up my mind about Odette. I will choose no other but her to be my bride.
But what if she doesn't show up?
I know she will show up. I have the utmost faith in Odette. Yes, I trust her.
Trying to flatter me. But, to tell you the truth, I was also thinking about tomorrow night's ball and about them dancing together and how wonderful it will be.
Margarita.
Don't you dare make fun of me, Hans. And what are you doing now?
What am I doing? Well, I was just,
You're so silly, Hans. Good night, Hans.
Oh, if she only knew how I feel.
Thank you.
wrong now?
The swans are all excited about something.
But why?
There must be something wrong.
Let's go and see.
Odette isn't here.
That's why they're so excited.
She's sick?
But for the last 3 years, she never failed to show up, not even a single day.
Then that means she is...
Hans, I think she's locked up in the castle of the terrible wicked wizard Rothbart.
And then she won't be able to go to the ball tonight at the castle.
That's right. And that would mean Prince Siegfried is going to be forced to choose somebody else for his bride.
What do we do now?
What can we really do?
What can we do?
I got it! I will go to the castle and tell Prince Siegfried all about it.
Tell the prince?
You know, we need his help to rescue Odette, and we can't do anything by ourselves.
Well, that's true.
And now, Hans, you go to Rothbart's castle and try to find out what he did with Princess Odette.
What? Go to the wizard's castle all by myself?
Well, don't you want to go? If you don't go, then you just better forget about marrying me, because I don't want to marry a coward.
All right, Margarita, don't get upset. I'll go.
Thank you.
Well, what could I say?
My feeling of love will never reach him.
I thought of a good idea. All I have to do is kill the prince.
Kill the prince?
Once the prince is gone for good, Odette will fall in love with me.
That won't work either, Father. Even if the prince is dead, the memory of him will remain in her heart forever. And the prince will keep living on in Odette's mind.
I'm afraid you are right about that. But then, how do I solve this? What'll I do?
There is one solution.
What? There is a solution?
Yes.
What is it? You must tell me. Hurry up, Odile.
Just make the prince fall in love with someone else.
But supposing Siegfried doesn't even blink an eye at anybody else except Odette, what do we do? Odile! Oh, Odette! Odette!
What are you doing, Father? I'm your daughter, Odile.
Well, you look so much like Odette for a moment, I made a mistake.
So, what do you say now? I'm sure Siegfried will fall in love with me.
Well, you really are my daughter, all right, to think up such a splendid idea like that. And now, if you dress up and go to the ball, I'm positive that Siegfried will fall in love with you at once.
And, Father, I wouldn't mind marrying Prince Siegfried myself. Is it all right, Father?
Of course it is. I'm all for it. Then I'll be free from worrying about the prince.
And then Odette will become your bride, Father.
I'm excited already.
Father, we're going to be busy tonight. Stop being so silly and get some sleep while you can.
Ah, that's right. Yes, I must get some sleep. And to all a good night.
Thank you. What's wrong?
That's funny. I thought I saw a squirrel just now. Maybe I was dreaming.
Hmm? A squirrel? Pretty brave, coming all the way up here. Lose your way? A cute squirrel.
That's right. He can't understand a word of my squirrel language. What'll I do?
You know, I wish you could take a message to Odette about tonight and ask her not to forget her promise and be sure to come. Now, back to the forest. What's wrong?
But when the drawbridge is up, how can I find out? Huh. I just have to remove the chain. All right. It's no good. It won't budge an inch.
Was that noise?
Oh, that was scary. Hey, I did it.
Something's been chewing on this. I bet it's a stupid rat.
Who? He thinks I'm a rat.
The sun will set very soon. And that's when the grand ball starts. I think I will go to the ball myself and see with my own eyes which girl Prince Siegfried will select for his bride. I'll enjoy that very much.
Oh, after all the trouble I went through.
Wait here, my little Odette. I will be going to the ball now. And tomorrow we will have our wedding ceremony. So look forward to the happy event.
Inside there. But the problem is how to open that big door.
Don't just stand there and talk about it. The ball's about to begin. Oh, Hans, what are you doing? Hurry up and go over to the other side and hang on to it.
All right.
Is Princess Katharina.
Happy birthday, Prince Siegfried.
Oh. Huh. Odette.
And next, Princess Rosanna.
Prince Siegfried, I wish you a very happy birthday.
Odette, please hurry. Odette.
My, this is an insult. My name is Francine. Oh!
Siegfried, I want you to choose the girl you like from among the princesses and ask her to dance with you.
Mother, I'm sorry, but I must confess that I have no intention of marrying anyone here.
Siegfried!
Everyone, I'm sorry to tell you the ball is over. Please accept my sincere apology to the princesses who have come such a long way.
Oh!
You may leave now.
Dead.
I knew that you would come, Odette.
I'm Odile.
What did you say? Odile?
Yes, I am Odile. I'm not Odette.
But last night...
Oh, I am sure that I said my name was Odile. I'm sure that you misheard me.
Perhaps I did, but names do not matter, Odile. Thank you for coming.
Who is that? The young lady dressed in black.
I do not know, but she is beautiful.
Siegfried seems to like her very much, and I am so relieved. Now, Minister, start the music.
Yes, start the music.
Thank you.
steal out of your room and run away. All right, I will show you something interesting. Take a good look.
Mother, and everyone present, I have an announcement to make. Today at my coming of age party, I would like you to meet Princess Odile, who will soon be my bride.
Oh, that's impossible!
I understand. If Siegfried is sincerely in love with the princess he has chosen, I have nothing against it.
Of course I am sincerely in love with her, and I take a vow to love Princess Odile for the rest of my life.
Oh.
What are you doing here?
Siegfried, at last you have taken a vow to love my daughter Odile all your life.
Love your daughter? Oh, no, you must be Rothbart.
That is correct. And now Princess Odette belongs to me.
Odette? Then who are you?
I told you that my name was Odile. It's too late to be shocked. You have already given your solemn oath that you will marry me, and you also vowed to love me all of your life.
Odette! Forgive me, Odette!
No matter how much you cry about it, now Odette belongs to me. Oh, you finally woke up, Odette. Oh.
Farewell, Prince Siegfried!
Odette! Wait for me, Odette!
Oh, here we go. Now, Odette, let's go.
Odette.
Now you belong to me.
Well done, my daughter, Odile.
Odette!
Please wait, Siegfried.
Mother,
are you aware of the danger? It's the wizard you are going to fight against.
Please forgive me, Mother. Regardless of the danger or the risk, I must go and rescue Odette.
From today, you are the king of this castle, and you cannot act as you please.
Mother, forgive me.
Siegfried!
Thank you.
cry all you want, but sooner or later you must learn to forget about Siegfried. Ah, Odette, I will be patient and wait for the day you will open your heart and marry me. Hmm?
Prince Siegfried!
That wet nose kid! I can't take any more! Ah!
Come on, Rothbard, fight!
Interesting. Do you really mean to fight me?
I came to rescue Odette.
Don't you realize who I am? I happen to be the great wizard Rothbard. Yeah! Oh!
Yeah!
Yeah!
Stop it, Siegfried!
Odette!
Oh, please run away, Siegfried. If you fight him, you'll be killed.
You needn't worry. My father will not kill Siegfried. He will just chase him away. Isn't that right, Father?
That's right. Because he has already pledged his love to you, why should I kill him? Since he is going to become your loving husband.
Father, be careful. Odette is running away.
What? My precious Odette!
Oh, it's the prince!
Where is she? Where did Odette go?
Odette!
Stop it, Odette. You know what will happen if you try and go against me.
Quick, you must leave here.
Odette, you must get away now. Don't worry, I came here to destroy Rothbart.
Siegfried, don't push your luck too far. I might just lose patience and kill you, even if you are pledged to my daughter, Odile. Yeah? Interesting. Come on, boy.
Do something to help the prince. If you want to marry me, help him.
All right, I will.
Try your best.
Siegfried, while you are still in good health, go on back to your castle. A little squirrel. Pesky little thing. Go away!
Oh, Hans! Oh, my dear Hans!
Well, they're still at it.
Listen to me. No matter how hard you try, it's useless. What a troublesome son-in-law you are. Well, what do you say now? If you give me your word to live in your castle with my daughter, Odile, I will spare your life.
Never. I will never marry your daughter.
Well, how dare you insult me?
Father, never mind. Just kill him off. Kill Siegfried.
All right. I will kill him. And here I go. Odette, watch this.
Stop it!
Please do not kill Prince Siegfried.
You want me to spare his life?
Let him live, please.
Don't let him live, Father. Kill him.
Odile, don't get excited. You know perfectly well I can kill him anytime I want. And now, Odette, if you want to save his life, all you have to do is say you'll marry me. Well now, Odette, if you want me to spare his life, you must give me your heart.
Don't do it, Odette. Forget about me. Don't do it. You must never give your heart to Rothbart.
Well, Odette, what do you say? Shall I finish him off?
Wait!
You can't, Odette!
Now, either you vow that you will love me forever, or are you going to let me kill Siegfried? Well?
Odette, I don't care about my own life!
Well, Odette?
I will love Rothbart with...
No!
Odette! Siegfried!
The strength of their true love has finally defeated the evil power of Rothbard's witchcraft. Hans, will you love me just as much as the prince loves Odette forever and ever?